In this video, we will talk about two other types of vaccines in development. Another modern approach is the use of viral vectors. In these types of vaccines, scientists use another virus that is called viral vector. And obviously, these vaccines contain a living component inside them. It is often modified to reduce its pathogenicity, and inside it they insert SARS-CoV-2 genetic material together with its own modified material. After the initial modification, some viral vectors cannot replicate, while others can, but they are weak. After the administration, the viral vector enters the cells and produces the proteins derived from SARS-CoV-2, and this action stimulates immune response against SARS-CoV-2 proteins. But during the development process, the scientists have a very important thing to consider, and that is whether our organism has immunity against the viral vector itself. For example, in some cases of COVID-19 vaccines, the immune system initially responded very well, but because some people had pre-existing immunity to the viral vector, the response was limited. So, the choice of the vector is important. A recent example of viral vector vaccine is the first vaccine against Ebola virus, which was approved in late 2019. These types of vaccines are the second most common platform for COVID-19 disease. University of Oxford, in partnership with AstraZeneca, and also Johnson & Johnson, Merck and many others, implement this strategy. Let's now talk about the pros and cons of these vaccines. Firstly, some vectors used can produce a strong immune response, and they may need only one administration, while others can be administered via the respiratory tract without injection, thus mimicking the natural route of infection. Another advantage is that, as happens with mRNA vaccines, we don't necessarily need to use the SARS-CoV-2 virus itself, making the whole development process safer and faster. A disadvantage could be, as we said, a probable immunity of the person who takes the vaccine against the viral vector. And also, the presence of a living component may associate with some additional side effects. And now, let's talk about the more classic approaches to vaccination. And an example of this is the use of the whole virus inactivated or killed. This is a strategy that has been used in other successful vaccines like the inactivated polio and hepatitis A. They do not contain live components of the virus. Usually, the inactivation takes place using thermal methods, chemical methods, or radiation. Companies like the Chinese Sinovac, Sinopharm, and many more develop these types of vaccines, and currently at least 7 of them are in the clinical phase of evaluation. With the injection, the inactivated virus enters the organism but cannot reproduce. Immune cells take the virus and they break it in small fragments, which similarly to the other vaccines they present to T lymphocytes. And so, they initiate a series of events that leads, among other things, to the production of antibodies by B lymphocyte, the destruction of the virus, and a possible production of B memory and T memory cells that will remember the virus. Advantages of this type of vaccines are that they are relatively stable and safe to use because they do not contain live components. Also, they have already been tested many times in the past with various diseases. The disadvantage is that the immune response to these vaccines is not usually very strong, and for that reason they often require the addition of an adjuvant, that is, as we said in the previous video, a molecule that enhances the immune response. Vaccines of this type that are in development right now require at least 2 doses. So, in the next and final video, we will talk about 2 other classic approaches to vaccination. Take care!